Newman is an interesting kettle of fish, a complex, intelligent man who's made a career out of playing the boof head. As an Aussie rules footballer, Sam flew high. On TV, he hits low, and that gets him into trouble. Plenty of trouble. Away from the cameras, it's much the same. His private life is one of multiple marriages and plenty of girlfriends. He's been run over, punched out, gone broke, and made a fortune. But in spite of this, or maybe because of it, for millions of viewers, Sam's the man. Sam Newman has only two speeds, flat out and over the top. One of Australia's highest paid television personalities, a man who's made a small fortune pushing the bounds of public taste. Since Melbourne's Footy Show began 8 years ago, Sam's offended just about everyone there is to offend. Some of the words that I read were used to describe you included clown, boofhead, arrogant, sexist, racist, politically incorrect, bully, bigot, ultra vain, homophobe, biased, bore, unmitigated pig.
Unmitigated pig. I think I'd draw the line at that. The rest are pretty fair, but I think unmitigated pig.
Does that stuff hurt?
Well, who said that? What piece of crud trots out that stuff about you that would make you worried? Critics are like eunuchs in a harem. They're there every night. They see it done every night. They see how it should be done every night, but they can't do it themselves.
He may have his critics, but Sam's also got his fans, legions of them, especially women. And it's perhaps not always his fertile mind that attracts them. How old are you, sir?
How old am I mentally? Physically, 55.
55?
55, yeah.
That's pretty good.
For being lasting to 55.
No, you look terrific.
You led the life I have on.
You don't mind the attention that this car brings you? Could be that you're a bit of a playboy.
Playboy? What is a playboy?
Do you
Someone
believe
who stands at a bar with their fly undone saying, come over here girls, would you like a drink? Is that a playboy?
Or
cruises down the street in a car with the horn going on, all that loud music rocking the back seat. Is that a playboy? What is a playboy?
Do you believe in monogamy?
Well, I believe in it. There's a lot of temptations though, isn't there? I mean, there's a lot of temptations.
Police say the former AFL footballer was punched in the face.
Sam's love life has certainly been well documented. He's been attacked by angry girlfriends, punched by jealous boyfriends, and spent more than the odd day in court. But none of this has dampened his enthusiasm for the fairer sex.
Yes, I'm heterosexual. Yep, I'm. No, that mightn't be politically correct or... You know, in this day and age, mightn't be the thing to say, but I am a heterosexual.
What is it you look for in a woman?
I look for in a woman.
Yeah, what attracts you?
Her eyes.
Do you believe that you will ever marry again?
Well, I don't believe I will, but I think James Bond, was it Ian Fleming who wrote the novel, Never Say Never? I'm not against the institution. Heaven knows I've had enough shots at it. I've had a crack at it. I just cannot get it to work. I can't get over the, I think, once between 3 and 5 years is my problem. If I can get it to last more than 5 years, I reckon I'll be home and hosed. I just can't get it across the line.
G'day, Sam Newman is my name.
Jack, your son.
Look, you're my son. Yeah. And you are...
Jordan, take on.
So you are. This is Liz Hayes.
Marriage for Sam wasn't a complete failure. It produced two loving sons, Jack and Jordan, who were raised by his third wife, Daisy. How would you describe your dad, Jordan?
tall.
Excellent.
Right. Doesn't wear his heart on his sleeve.
No, he hides a bit, doesn't he?
He does. He does.
Sort of pretends almost, doesn't it?
He does.
I haven't heard this stuff before.
No. Shield. You can't get through it.
And Jack, I think you've said that you felt your dad should be going out with women more his own age.
A girl he used to go out with was younger than I am.
Was that distressing?
A little bit.
Why?
I was tempted to have a crack myself.
Do you think you've been a good example?
No, I'm sure that they find it very hard in life to live down the fact that I'm their father.
John Newman coming in using the drop cut. Oh, stopping, but looks like being on...
With all the controversy that surrounds him, it's sometimes easy to forget Sam Newman was a champion footballer, a dynamic ruckman who played 300 games for Geelong over 18 years. Football was a fairly significant event in your life.
Yes, it probably stopped me from working in a bank all my life, opened a few doors, gave me some opportunities. You know, not everyone's born equal, don't let anyone tell you that.
Was it your passion?
Yes. Yes, it was. That was probably the only thing I was good at, playing football. Sad, isn't it?
Hey, have you had a check? Seriously.
Yeah,
that could be your brain. Your brain might have moved into that little lump there.
He's still quick on his feet, but these days, Sam shoots from the lip.
Sam, I'll bare my bum on this track if he wins this race.
I don't think we've got a wide enough lens, mate.
His weekly forays into the game's heartland have become a firm fixture with footy fans.
Now hang on, just a minute, Matt. There's a woman sizing up my whizzer here. Just hang on a minute, will you?
But this former great is certainly no man of the people.
Deep as it is to put sort of facial hair on you and pretend you're someone else.
Yeah, I know.
Most people are so ignorant, it's frightening.
Do you think so?
Yep, absolutely. See, you don't ever deal with the public. You wouldn't know what the public are. And most of them are very simple, plain, nice people, and a hell of a lot have just come down from the hills with their knuckles dragging on the ground. They're tree swingers. And they love it. They're very happy. But I don't know why people get excited when you say they're pretty dumb and they're pretty stupid.
Sorry I'm late, mate.
His humour is rarely subtle, often crude. But when Sam lampooned Aboriginal player Nicky Winmar, it was beyond the pale.
I know everything. I know all the players.
Was the Nicky Winmar incident a low point?
Not at all. No. That was one of the most hysterically overrated, forelock-tugging pieces of hysteria that possibly has been let go in the Western world.
But you were tagged a racist.
Well, by whom? Who? I couldn't care less. I tried to impersonate a man who was black, an Aboriginal, Nicky Winmar, who was a bloody good bloke. And I thought the best way to impersonate him is to paint my face black. That would just generally give people the indication that I was going to be like Nicky Winmar.
And Nicky Winmar, wasn't he the most important person in all of this?
Yes, he was. Very good man, Nicky Winmar.
He showed some sensitivity about
Nicky
it at the time.
Nicky Winmar was driven to feel like he did by do-gooders, sympathisers, hangers-on.
So he didn't
bludgers.
Really feel the way he presented you.
I don't believe he did.
And we've got a pump-up hammy.
It was frontman Eddie Maguire who finally brokered an uneasy peace. Riding shotgun for Sam has become something of an occupational hazard.
Generally, I've been able to throw myself on the grenade, but sometimes it's impossible. You don't know what's going on there. And he's always just trying to push the envelope to the edge, and occasionally when you're doing that all the time, it's going to go over. And I think sometimes Sam lives in such a funny lifestyle that what is normal to him is absolutely abnormal to everybody else.
Some said he was a genius. Others said he was mad. To most, he was just a very naughty boy.
Just when you think you've seen it all, Sam manages to go that little bit further. When Hawthorn captain Shane Crawford decked him on national television, the normally unflappable Sam struggled to rise to the occasion.
Well, that could have been very embarrassing, Sammy, if anyone here had had a magnifying glass.
You have a peck of it's almost public property.
Yeah, I was a bit disappointed about that. I mean, you know, if ever you wanted to know was it set up that or not, well, of course it wasn't, because if it had been, I would have made sure I was, you know, like I'm a bit better than that, to be honest. But, you know, when it's all sort of squashed up under the clothes you're wearing and you're sitting down behind a bit of a desk, I mean, give us half a chance and I can get people to say, wow, gee, did you see that? But now they went, did you see that?
Well, is that the thing that is disappointing? That people will make a judgment on size?
God, turn it up. Wait, now, honestly and truly.
Were you embarrassed?
I was embarrassed. I was shocked. I was actually took me by surprise.
Did you get much comment at the time?
About the
personally?
Oh, plenty. Yeah. Yeah.
Saying what?
Oh, saying how small it was, and it was really almost sent me into a monumental decline. I nearly thought of surgery.
Here we go. Stand back, mate.
Oh. While his public persona is one of the shameless exhibitionists, in private, Sam Newman is a surprisingly serious man. He lives alone in a salubrious Bayside mansion, and only here, in the company of close friends, he feels truly at ease.
I'm not as ebullient and outgoing as, not as confident as a lot of people.
You're not?
No.
Not as optimistic.
I'm a bit of a pessimist. I tend to come from the other end. I tend to start off thinking something's not going to work or not be good, and then if it does, that's a bonus.
Hello, mate.
Oh, well, presentation. Got six hats for this.
You don't wear your emotions on your sleeve.
No. Very dangerous thing to do that.
Why is it dangerous?
Oh, because you give people an opportunity to see what makes you tick.
And you don't want them to see
that? No, of course you don't. Why do you want people to see what makes you tick? Then you become exposed and vulnerable.
Maybe the public doesn't deserve to see any more. They get enough
already. Maybe the public couldn't be less interested. You never know. One day, universally, they might say, now, this man is a dickhead, and I've had enough of him, and that is it. That is all. Won't that be bliss?